pencil me under the diamonds. See me like breath in the cold. Sleep with me here in the silence. Come kiss me silver and gold. You say that I will lose you, but you can't predict the future. So just hold on like you will never let go. If you ever move on without me, to make sure you know that you are the only one I'll ever love. Yeah, you, if it's not you, it's not anyone. Looking back on my life, you're the only good I've ever done.
At its finest, like you wanted in before the door was open, instead of letting what's scripted play out. Quit acting like we're in a race,
begging me, you know I'm on the way over. Take a moment to cherish this space. So quick to move forward, no pressure, and we've got the rest. Got the rest of our lives. We got the rest. Got the rest of our lives. All you ever really want, all you ever really need is at home. Yeah, we've got the rest. Got the rest of our lives.
If I could be honest, here in this moment, I've been so nervous to stand here with you. They're all here for us, and I feel their aura, but just for a moment, I'll pretend it's just you. Yes, they can hear us, but they don't understand. I have said all of my vows behind the curtain. I know they see us, but they don't stand a chance. I have kissed those lips a thousand times before this. Tomorrow I'll open my eyes, and I will whisper to my wife, I belong to you. And I will wait to hear you say, as a tear rolls down your face, I belong to you. I belong with you. When they let us choose, I will say I do. I belong.
Danielle and Christian, have you come here freely today to give yourselves wholeheartedly to marriage?
Yes.
Are you prepared to follow the path of marriage and to love and honor each other for as long as you shall both live?
Yes.
And are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and His church?
Yes.
Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, I want you now to join your right hands and look each other in the eye and repeat after me.
I, Christian, take you, Danielle, to be my wife. I promise to be true to you in good times and bad, in sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you all the days of my life.
I, Dana, take you, Christian, to be my husband. I promise to be true to you in good times and bad, in sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you all the days of my life.
You declared your consent before God and the church, and before we seal this consent, our bride and our groom wrote their own special little words that they wanted to say to each other, their own personal vows as well.
To my best friend, Danielle Testoni, my life became infinitely better the day you became part of it. From that day on, I knew I had to do whatever it took to be standing where I am today. Your beautiful smile, your sense of humor, your passion and drive, I knew we were a perfect match. You never feel like showing how much you care about me, even on my worst days. You're the absolute love of my life, and there's never been anyone else for me. I want to spend the rest of my days with you. I want to start a family with you. And I want us to live a happy life together. I cannot wait to call you my wife. I've dreamt of this day since I was 15, and now my dreams are coming true. I promise this love will never fade, and I vow to always be true to our commitment, true to our love, and to always be your best friend.
It's making me cry. It's so beautiful. That is so beautiful.
Chris, the man you have become, a true gentleman that never ceases to amaze me. You always want the best for me, whatever makes me happy. We've been together for over 10 years. We've grown up together. Now people would say you're lucky, but it's not luck. Because we did this. We had the best of times, but we also took bad times and really bad times. We have learned, we have grown, we have changed. We never gave up. That is commitment, that is loyalty, that is us. And you are the person I want to spend my whole life with. 10 years down, forever to go. I'm so grateful to be able to do life with you. I'd be so proud to call you my husband. I give you my hand, my heart, and my all from this day forward, as long as we both shall live.
Beautiful.
Danielle, take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Christian, take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
It is now my great honor and privilege to present to all of you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Christian
down in five. The smell of your perfume is floating down the stairs. You're fixing up your hair like you do. I know that I'll be a mess the second that I see you. You won't be surprised. It happens every time. It's nothing new. Always on a night like tonight, I thank God you can read my mind. 'Cause when you look at me with those eyes, I'm speechless. Staring at you, standing there in that dress. What it's doing to me ain't a secret. 'Cause watching you is all
was a boat stuck in a bottle that never got the chance to touch the sea. Just forgot on the shelf, no wind in the sails, going nowhere with no one but me. I was one in 100 billion, a burnout star in a galaxy. Just lost in the sky, wondering why everyone else shines out for me. But I came to life when I first kissed you. The best me has his arms around you. Can make me better than I was before. Thank God I'm yours. I was a worn out set of shoes, wandering the city streets. Another face in the crowd, head looking down, lost in the sound of a lonely melody. And empty pockets and a roulette, always landing on a lost bed. Just live for the spin and hope for the wind. Go all.
I'll take the slow, sweet walk with you. You letting go of my hand to say I do.
he will discover just how blessed life can be. I know, 'cause all those years ago, someone handed you to me. Every step that we take brings back the memories. Winter snows and horse shows and dancing on the beach. I can't help thinking that I'm the lucky one. You're still my baby daughter, and now I've gained a son.
You know there's a light that glows by the front door. Don't forget the keys under the mat. When childhood stars shine, always stay humble and kind. Go to church 'cause your mama says to. Visit grandpa every chance that you can. It won't be wasted time. Always stay humble and kind. Hold the door, say please, say thank you. Don't steal, don't cheat, don't lie. I know you got mountains to climb, but always stay humble and kind. When the dreams you're dreaming come to you, when the work you put in is realized, let yourself feel the pride, but always stay humble and kind. Don't expect a free ride from no one. Don't hold a grudge or a chip, and here's why.
Hi everyone, I am Kara, Danielle's maid of honor and younger but taller sister. I can't believe this day has finally come. This beautiful couple right here has honestly been through it all. As I stand next to the both of you with tears in my eyes, it makes me the happiest sister in the world to know that you two have each other, and with each other, you have and will conquer the world. Growing up, Danielle was always known to be the quiet one. But in my eyes, she was not a quiet girl. She knew and still knows exactly what she wants. When we were younger, we would play this game where we sat at the top of the stairs. The rule was the last person to name a game at the bottom of the steps would win. There was no ifs, buts, no ifs, ands, or buts about playing that specific game. I always thought Danielle was just being like a nice sister by letting me go first. Little did I know, there was a plan behind it. Danielle always began with shopping, next was me banker, and so on. We would get to the last step. So happily and excitedly, I would pick school and teacher. And suddenly Danielle would just look at me and say, no. Every time we got to the bottom of the stairs, no matter what I said, it didn't matter. Because guess what? If I didn't agree with her, we didn't play. So moral of the story here, Chris, if you want Danielle to be happy and agree with you, she always gets the last choice. Danielle and I are always inseparable. always try to put himself in between the middle of the two of us or whistle at us to move away whenever we are around because we never let anyone sit or be in between us. He always used to turn to my grandma and whisper, "Siempre están juntas," meaning they're always together. Where you find me, you will find my sister. And where you find my sister, you will find me. My grandpa always thought that this would change when we found our significant others, but he was mistaken. Chris walked into this family with a big, big heart, ready for whatever came his way. But he knew the bond between my sister and I would never change. And we, being always attached at the hip, would remain forever. Chris would come over in the morning hours and stay until late. I couldn't understand it at first. I always wanted to go back to the times that it was me and Danielle at the top of the stairs. One day, I was sitting at the top of the stairs remembering the times that my sister and I would play our game. Danielle came along, sat right down next to me, and said, "Kara, you'll understand one day." And guess what? I definitely do. Even though the stairs game came to a halt as we grew up, the love that these two share remains the same. After watching Danielle and Chris grow into the beautiful bride and groom that they are today, I understand the time, love, and commitment that was spent dedicating their lives to each other. Those four aspects, time, love, commitment, and dedication, brought them here today. Every time Chris is around, Danielle is the happiest. Her face glows, her day brightens, her heart remains fulfilled, all because of this special man sitting next to her. They are the small town home, they're the small hometown love story. Chris and Danielle, I have watched you both grow from just ordinary Haworth public school classmates to now husband and wife. And I cannot wait to see what this life has in store for the both of you. I wish you both love, health, and happiness. But just always remember, Chris, Danielle always gets the last choice. Cheers to you both as you begin this new chapter in your life as Mr. and Mrs. Christian Vargas.
Good evening, everyone. All right, so before I begin, can we all take a second to applaud the amazing job done by the parents of both the bride and the groom in not only allowing these two to exist, but also helping put together this incredible wedding. Danielle, you look beautiful tonight. Chris, you do too. So, as a friend to both the bride and the groom since kindergarten, I'm in a bit of an interesting position. I know them both extremely well. In fact, I almost feel like I had a chance at being Danielle's maid of honor, but she ended up going with Kara. It was a smart decision, don't get me wrong. All jokes aside, I couldn't be more honored to have been selected as your best man. Chris and I have been through a lot through our 20 years of friendship. Through the many ups and downs, I think the reason that we have been able to hold on to this friendship for so long is because it has been so impactful in shaping who we are as individuals. For instance, back in middle school, Chris was more of the athlete between the two of us. You know, he was good at sports. I was just like, you know, trying to fit in and act like I had an interest in sports. But we were actually on the same team in eighth grade on the basketball team. might be a surprise, but yeah, I played basketball in eighth grade. And there was one game in particular. Don't get me wrong, I spent most of my time on the bench. But there was one game in particular where I was able to actually score a basket. And when that moment happened, like, I think I leapt up in the air. I shouted, yes, like, I looked like an idiot. But I felt like I was on top of the world. It might have even been a three-pointer. Who knows? I think it was. We'll say that it was. Chris came over to me. He gave me a high five. And the funny thing is, Chris also scored a basket that same game, except he scored it for the other team. Somehow he got, like, turned around. I don't know what happened, but, like, he went on the other side and scored a basket. And, like, I remember his reaction. He was like, what? Oh, my God. Like, he was... I have no idea how that happened. But, I mean, I don't know if Chris was doing that at the time to help me build my confidence, because, like, you know. But at that time, my mindset was basically, yeah, I'm not that good, but at least I never did that. But in all seriousness, I really do believe that Chris was essential in helping me become the man I am today, more confident, independent, and true to myself. Chris has always believed in me. It's almost like you were able to see my true potential before I even saw it in myself. See, the thing about Chris and I, we get each other. One moment, we could be roasting one another. Seriously, he does a really good impression of me. And in the next moment, we can be giving each other life advice on anything from work to relationships to mental health. We've never been afraid to be brutally honest to each other. And if things are ever taken too far, we can acknowledge it, apologize, and move on. When Chris told me he was going to propose to Danielle, I got a little emotional, as I am right now. I always knew they were a perfect match, but seeing Chris finally reach that moment where he was ready to make it official just showed me how much he had grown as a person. And it was inspiring for me to see him so confident in something, and made me want to continue my growth in hopes that I could one day achieve that same sense of certainty. Danielle, thanks for being the best thing that's ever happened to Chris. You know how much I appreciate you and all our good times together. If Chris ends up being half as good at being my friend, If Chris ends up being half as good at being your husband as he has been at being my friend, then you're guaranteed to have a wonderful, fun-filled, and amazing life together. To Chris and Danielle.
Some kind of magic that lies underneath could have been tragic, but we found the peace. Sheets we go. Work hard and sleepless and wait for the dream. No time to regret what we haven't seen. Letdowns and freakouts and storm clouds and ice below. We made it out. Good life, cause we got no bad time. Yeah.
leaders to these.